This is Chaishop.com music news. Number 5. This show is presented by DJ Mikadho and Chaishop. Presenting the finest psychedelic trance, progressive trance, and chill out tunes tonight. And telephone artist interview with Evan Blutek from Canada. The unreleased track of the week and the oldie of the week.
And as always, the best reviews you can get on the net.
Yeah. Track from the new Spin Drive compilation, which is released on Centris Records. More about this compilation later in the show.
Last time you heard her, both of us were sick. Sam was sick too. Now only I'm sick. That's just because it's really cold in Germany.
Especially in Hamburg.
I'm gonna go take my temperature. As you listen to this track.
My temperature is very high tonight. We got some very good wine. Still in Brazil. He's enjoying the summer. all the best to them. If you really like our show, please send us some feedback to cmn@chaishop.com. And if you don't like our show, do as well. We might do something better to improve it in the future.
Many thanks to all the people who gave us feedback in the past. As we said in the last show, much feedback. Thank you very much.
Welcome to the full-on part of our show. Full-on high energy, call it what you want, it always rocks the floors.
Last show we had some problems with the mic. So we decided to spend a bit more money and to buy a better mic, which I hope which was this better.
You should see the mic. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Cheers, mate.
Woo.
served with a typical amount of loud and low
What were those words?
Well, anyway, this is track number 2 from the new Planet Ben compilation called Generations of Psytrance. You can buy it at your favorite psychedelic trance dealer. And this track has a nice combination of acts. It's called Squatted D-Tech Remix, and it is composed by Ultraplex. Ultraplex is a combination of Ultra Voice and Perplex from Israel, which you might know already. And it is remixed by D-Tech from Mexico, which is really bringing out some high-energy, mind-blowing music on the dance floor. Well, this combination is not only with names like Ultraplex and D-Tech, it also has, like it always has been on Planet Ben Records, other great names like Electric Universe, Mechanica, Planet Ben, Electro Sun, and Talamasca. Get it from a DJ near you at the next party.
Funny, Planet Ben Records is known for full-on and real psychedelic stuff, and he released the compilation. It is compiled by DJ Magical from Germany, called Area 51, which is very progressive and very groovy. More about this compilation in our next show.
and this is... Zedman. Probably all have heard from this guy, not a Zedman, but Zedman is Jonas Bergvall from Sweden. He also used to play in great projects like Hux Flux and Logic Bomb. And this is a new track from his new release, or maybe his first album to be exact, called Vamos Cabrón on Ajuka Productions. A little bit of Spanish to spice up your life. And all you of you want to be Latinos. Gotta get this album, it's amazing. Somebody had to say amazing tonight. By the way, this is the first time we're doing a show at normal hours. We're not falling asleep. We're in full control of our senses and really enjoying it. It took Jonas 2 years to do this album, and man, what an album he did.
I'm not a big full-on lover, but this album, I really like.
Is everything okay with you, Miko? Are we trading places or something? What the hell is going on? Well, Miko is the kind of guy who likes to shake his ass to progressive.
I like to make the ladies dance.
You ladies, man, you.
No
normally it stems part of the show.
But he has to drink a little bit in order to be like that. Don't worry.
Everybody out there, calm down a bit. We now come to the progressive part of our show.
I'll be right back. Enjoy Miko's voice for the meantime.
Listening to Zinc right now. Zinc is also known as Vaishya. And Vaishya is known as Hannes DJ Buratino, who is running this label called Spin Twist. And this compilation called Spin Drive. Spin Twist record is very fresh. It was founded this year and this compilation is the first release. This compilation contains 8 progressive trance tracks and an ambient bonus track from Colaris. All the artists on this compilation are well known, for example, Symphonics, the Chitraka brothers, Hannes himself as Vaishyas and Zing Track, you're listening to right now. Neo Liquid Soul 1, Monotone, and many more. It is a high quality trance release which you shouldn't miss. And I'm really looking forward to the next releases. The next one will be the new Waishias album called Flexible. And after this, the Spin Drive series continue with the chapter 2 and 3.
If you like what you're hearing, and if you're in Hamburg next week, the 16th of December, we're going to be playing at the Club Stensis together with Vaishya, Sam, and Chaishop, Mikadho, and me, Oscar. So, let's see if we all meet there.
Freelander. This album called Up Nerve. And it is released on Synergetic Records from Austria. Gerd Schlichting is called Freelander and he's from Austria too. And he's an old electric guy. He's working since about 15 years in the electronic scene now. Wow. Musical roots go back to the 80s when he was a band member of an electronic act called Rain. One of the only electropop bands in Austria those days. His roots can be found in melodic, synthpop and electronic body music, which you can hear on several tracks on this album, which I like very much. Ah. the tracks are some kind of melodic trance with some tribal but also pop and rave influences. But it never seems like commercial trance, if you know what I mean. Some of the tracks for me are perfect for sunny morning parties if you like to bring the girls back on the floor.
Oh, listen, everybody's so happy.
But at the end, I must say, I don't like every track on this album. There's some tracks on it which I think I will play in my next DJ set, but there are also some tracks on it which are too poppy and, yeah, I don't like so much. But it's really worth to check it out. From this show, the DJ interview in this week is made together with Evan Bluecheck from Canada, and Sam made this interview from Brazil. It is a telephone interview, and yeah, it will come after this track. Lovers out there, we also got a DJ set from Evan. You can download the DJ set also at www.chaishop.com/musicnews or subscribe to the podcast.
Don't forget to send us your comments to CMN, CMN at chaishop.com.
This is Chaishop Music News. I'm talking with Evan of Blue Tech, a great chill-out live act from Canada. And this is actually a telephone conversation. Evan, where are you now?
I'm currently in San Francisco.
All right. What's up in San Francisco?
I'm playing a release party for my new CD, Signs and Singularities, tomorrow night. And tonight I am at a record store called Ambient Airlines and giving out posters and selling CDs and signing CDs and meeting everyone.
All right. Sounds nice. So it's basically something like a release event of your new CD.
Absolutely.
All right, cool.
So,
and
there was a
How is it going? What is happening exactly? What's your impression?
Sam, you're cutting out on me again. Say that last sentence again.
Okay, sorry. What's happening there? What's your impression? What are you exactly doing?
We just kind of opened the store, so people are starting to come in. They're getting a glass of wine, and I believe that they're going to start playing my album soon. It's like a listening party, so everybody will listen to the album.
All right.
So I just got the CDs in. I opened the box for the first time, just pulled the brand new CDs out and looked at the posters and everything.
Wow, that's really that's really special to hear that for me as a European. really celebrated as a special event. So, like, everybody sits down, listens to your music, and then after that, probably claps hands and congratulates. So.
Yep. And then tomorrow is a big party, and I'll play all of the new tracks live, and I'll play some unreleased tracks and some remixes and some stuff that I've been working on since the tracks that were created for this last album. So I think it'll be very exciting, actually.
Okay, cool. How long are you going to stay in San Francisco for?
I'm here until Sunday, and then I fly back to Seattle.
All
and
right.
I'm actually... I will visit some family and do some other things in December, driving around a bunch. I'm trying to take some time off if possible. I've been traveling since May of this year, playing shows almost every weekend, it seems like. So it's been about 6.5-7 months of touring now, and I'm getting ready to settle down for the winter and make some new music.
Wow, so 6-7 months touring around the world. And playing your music.
Yep,
so, tell me.
It's very strange. I'm exhausted from being on the road, but I try not to complain too much because it's probably the best day job I could have of anyone in the world. I get to travel around and hang out with cool people like Sam from Chaishop and go to big parties and eat new food and meet new people. So it's pretty cool. I mean, I don't have to sit at a desk and answer telephones, you know. I get to go to parties and that's my job. Yeah, it's pretty nice.
Wow. And so this makes a little bit the impression to me that you sort of take one big time for a tour and then take one big time for not touring so much. Is that right?
I hadn't actually planned it that way. I put out my first record in 2003 and booked some shows to support that first album, and then 2004 was much bigger. I had two more artists touring with me, and then Solar Fields came out and toured with me, so there was a block, like the whole summer. We did North America, and then we did Europe. This last summer, Shulman came and did shows with me, and I didn't actually plan on being on the road this long. It just seemed like shows kept happening, and people would be really excited, and they'd go back to their town and talk about it, and a promoter would contact me, and it just seemed like it kept going and going, and next thing you know, it's 6 months later, and I haven't been home yet, you know? So I didn't, consciously set out to tour all year. It just kind of happened that way, and now I'm being a little bit more conscious about it. I'm taking time off to make new music for the summer, and then maybe May or June I'll start touring again and do... I mean, hopefully not 6 months this year. I think 3 months or 4 months is enough time to be traveling.
All right. Yeah, I mean, I think this is a very big subject for artists that get successful, that after some time you can tour all the time, and if you do that, you don't find time anymore to produce your music, actually.
It's true. I produce as much music as I can on the road. I mean, for me, my music has always been something that I create on the computer. I don't have keyboards and all these instruments. Everything I make with software. So this means that, you know, I'm sitting in the airport in Portugal and I have a couple hours to kill. I can put on my headphones and work on a track or work on a remix or do things like this. So this has allowed me to get more work done than artists who have tons and tons and tons of studio gear and need to be at home before they can write music. So it works out pretty well.
Okay, that sounds amazing. So basically you're not reliant on the studio gear. How does it work, like making music while you're traveling? I mean, you're pretty much distracted by events which happen in between, like, for example, your plane is leaving or something like that, yeah? How does it work for you?
How does it work for me writing music between shows? I like it, actually. It's a very present experience. It's like I can, you know, this feeling when you've been at a good festival or a good party and you've seen all your friends, you've met new people and you have this charge about life. And, you know, for a lot of people on tour, by the time they get home, they've lost that feeling. They forget what made that event so special. I have this laptop with me, so I can actually be at a party, and this happens all the time. Something magical happens, something that I want to remember, that I want to capture. I'm able to go within my tent and sketch out an idea really quickly, or I don't know. I feel like I can translate my experience in real time almost and make music and then give it right back to people. So it's been really effective for me. It's allowed me to write, I think, more directly for the people that are coming to the shows, because I'm in the middle of being at the shows, you know?
Wow, that's a really interesting way to work. Also, this looks like technology changes the capabilities how we produce music, yeah? I mean, not only in the way of making different sounds, but also, as you say that, yeah?
It affects working method as well. I can write a track on the weekends or during the week, and I play it out on Saturday, and maybe the first half of the track works really, really well, and everybody's smiling on the dance floor, and then they look kind of lost during the last half, and I feel like I've lost them, and I got to do something drastic to get them back. Then I know that this track has been finished, and it needs some work in the last half. After the party, I can spend a couple days, I can fix it. By the time I'm at the next party, the next weekend, the track is closer and more powerful. It's like I get a direct feedback from people of how the music is working for them. I can see how they respond to it, and this definitely affects the tracks before they're finished for me. I get to kind of test them out on people, so it's really nice.
Wow, that's great. That's great. Okay, let me ask you some other questions. Why did you actually start to make music?
I don't feel like I had a choice. I was a very strange kid, maybe 4 years old, 5 years old. All I wanted to do was listen to classical music, and I wanted to be a piano player. I loved Beethoven and Chopin and Debussy, and all I wanted to do was play music. So at a very, very early age, my parents realized that I was perhaps obsessive about sound, and I started with piano lessons. So that's never really changed for me. Music is something that is a part of me so much that it's like my breath. I breathe it in through my ears, and I breathe it out through the music that I make.
All right, so it's not that you were looking out for the music, it's that the music was looking out for you.
I feel like the music chose me. So I have
cool.
I have to do it. I don't think I'd be happy if I wasn't making music.
Uh-huh. And okay, you're living in Canada. Is Canada a special place to make ambient music?
Canada is an incredible, incredible country. The place where I've been staying is called the Sunshine Coast. It's on the west coast of British Columbia, and it's like a special type of family there. It feels very much like a community, like a. These activities that we see modeled at parties, where it's kind of like a temporary community, like there's a tribal market, there's healers, everyone is kind of being together, and there's this feeling of family. Well, I found that in Canada, on the Sunshine Coast, it's like this 365 days a year. Everyone is working with each other. Everyone goes down and spends time with each other in the morning at the same coffee shop. People eat meals together at each other's houses. There's this sense of family, of tribe almost. And I was very, very attracted to that feeling of really feeling like I was in a community, which it seems like is very hard to find in the Western world. We're so inundated with separations and kind of boxes that just define who people are. I found a place that wasn't separate. It was actually a unified place. The community was really special for me, which is why I chose to be there.
Uh-huh. And why is this happening exactly in Canada?
I think it's a number of things. I think some visionary people moved there or lived there and started building something really special. And I think there's a liberal, relaxed government that allows people freedom of expression and support the arts. There's tons of amazing, incredible, pristine land around, beautiful, vibrant forests and waterfalls. And I think all of these things kind of combine to create an environment that's very conducive to this type of community and scene.
All right. Yeah, sounds really, really interesting. And if you would recommend a place in Canada that visitors should not miss, what would you say?
Say that question one more time.
If you would have to recommend a special place or area that visitors, tourists that come to Canada should not miss, what would you say?
I would definitely say British Columbia. The Sunshine Coast is beautiful. Vancouver Island is beautiful. The whole kind of British Columbia West Coast thing is beautiful. There's really not anything bad about it. So that sounds. If you want hiking, there's hiking. If you want skiing and snowboarding, you can do that. If you want parties, there's parties there. So.
Okay. Yeah. So cool. That's so far about Canada. Coming back to your music. In my opinion, you created a very special own style of chill out or ambient music. How would you define your style? How would you define your music?
That's a really hard question. I think sometimes musicians are too close to their own music to be able to get perspective on it. It's like a painter who's been staring at their work too long and they don't see it anymore. I would like to think that my music has some roots in traditional ambient music, like the early Waveform catalog, the ambient desktop, ambient dub, and beyond records stuff that was coming out, Higher Intelligence Agency, mm-hmm. Sounds from the Ground, stuff like this was definitely a big influence. So I think that what I'm trying to do is bring this kind of classic ambient dub sound and make it more modern, include experimental textures and IDM textures and more kind of cutting-edge technology into the process. So sometimes I joke that my music is IDM, intelligent dub music.
Yeah.
I don't know, I think the critics are better at describing it than I am.
If I would ask you what your music is for, what would you say?
That's an interesting question. I would say that first and foremost, it's a way for me to process my own life. It's a healing process. It is to understand myself, to understand emotions, to understand things that have occurred in my life. Second, I'd say it's for healing for other people, to make a soundtrack for their experience so that they can find deeper connections and find their source and find their healing.
Okay. Wow. Yeah, that's nice. Last question. You have a new album coming out now that you are actually just presenting in San Francisco.
I'm just presenting it now. It's released on December 5th.
Yeah. And you had, one or two albums before.
There was a one full-length album and one EP.
Ah, okay, that was it.
So this is technically the second album.
Okay, so if people wonder now what they are going to expect, how would you describe the changes or differences or meaning of your new album?
I think this album is a little bit bigger sounding. It's because so much of this record was written while I was traveling and touring and playing dance floors and writing music that would kind of work for people that were coming to the show. I think maybe this record has more... I don't want to say dance floor because it's not dance floor. It's chill out music, but I think there's like maybe stronger beats in there somehow. The tempos are a little bit faster. It's a little bit more... There's like more power to it somehow. The tracks carry a little bit more weight. They're not so dreamy and atmospheric. They're thicker somehow. Does that make sense?
Yeah, okay. For me, it makes sense. Okay, cool. So, yeah. I would say thank you very much for the interview. Would you like to say anything specific else to the public?
I can't think of anything off the top of my head.
All right.
I'll see everybody this summer when I come to play more shows.
Yeah. So you will be in Europe in the summer. I also want to point that out to the people. You will be in Europe for two months. Is it right? I remember right.
I'm planning on being in Europe. We'll see how the bookings go and which shows line up, but I definitely will be over there this summer.
Okay, so super cool.
Bringing some special guests with me this year as well.
Yeah. Yeah, so everybody who sees Blue Tech or Evan Blue Tech on the menu of some festival or party, definitely check him out. It's an amazing live act. And you also play DJ sets. And we're going to have one DJ set at the end of this show to make people experience your DJ set also.
Wow, this was really interesting. And funny because we are here in Hamburg in Germany, Sam is in Brazil, Mr. Blue Tech is in Canada, and yeah, we're doing this show together. Welcome back to Chaishop.com Music News. You're listening now to the unreleased track of the week. Which is from Kulares. Wow, much Kulares tonight. But Kulares is DJ Molecular from Hamburg, very nice guy and a very close friend, and he's really worth to talk about. This track called Speaking Clear. Also working together with DJ Zangit under the name Zalaris.
They played a great set at the Woof Experience this year. They also made a track on the last Trance's Guide to the Galaxy compilation. Where we preparing the next chapter at Chaishop.com together with Mushroom Magazine for the next year.
Trance's Guide to the Galaxy is the travel guide for every trancer, and this year there might be a new compilation going with it, with new, fresh, unreleased tracks from all over the world.
This is the concept.
Wait until you see the results.
One of our next shows, we're gonna make an artist interview together with DJ Molecular. Out there listening to the show right now, and if you like this track, just get in contact with CMN@chaishop.com. Or speak to DJ Molecular, who will play on several festivals next year. Definitely.
It's easier to send us a mail if you really want this track. CMN@chaishop.com.
So you got it twice.
yourself from Chill Out. Part of our show. If we shot you all over to the moon and back to Mars and Pluto, it's time for you to come back to Earth. We're calling you back. Please come back. Seems like Austria. Austria? Are we back on Earth? Is Austria on planet Earth? It's in a place called Europe, I think. Yeah, we are back on Synergetic Records. From Mexico, who you might know from his main project Smuck. Under this alter ego, he just has released an album on AP Records called Balam. We are now at the chill out part, and let's talk about this chill out release. You can find 13 unreleased high quality mellow tracks on this CD. Beautiful chill out album with many different styles on it. There are lots of instruments in his tracks, like guitars and stuff, and there are some housey tracks. Sound range from groovy chill out with some fungal influences to typical known Ibiza sounds, but without the pop shit in it. I can imagine to listen to it at the beach with a cold drink and just watching the sea.
Too bad my daughter can't join us.
I'm sorry, did everybody understand that?
Too bad Madonna can't join us. No pop this time.
I think we all need a little break right now, because we now come to the oldie of the week, and it's much more up-tempo, and one of my favorite oldies of the week, not of the week.
Of all time.
Yeah.
Check it out. It's only this week you're gonna listen to it.
Yeah. Welcome on planet Aldolion. I listened to this track, it totally blew me away. It is from the first Aldolion album, which was released on Freeform Records. I think everybody of you out there knows this track, because it was for me. Was played on every party, and yeah, what a nice track.
Thank you.
so many great releases on Freeform Records. Shame that it's closed. I was working for Freeform Records for about 2 years. It was a great time. Thank you very much for this.
I really hope you enjoyed it this time as much as we did, as always.
This place is everything.
Don't forget to check out www.chaishop.com/musicnews for every new episode of Music News, and for additional trance-related information, don't forget to visit the Chaishop website. Feedback is always welcome at cmn@chaishop.com, and I guess I have to say goodbye now. Goodbye! See you next time!
Thanks to all you listeners out there, also from Mikadho. Bye bye.